Hey guys, this is Mike from Wooly Bugged. It is Saturday, April 15th, and I am out in Western PA, out near Homer City, Indiana, Pennsylvania, on Yellow Creek at the Yellow Creek Trout Club. I'm out here to meet a friend today, and I'll tell you what, this is the first weekend this month, actually the first weekend in like a month, that we've had some pretty good water flows where the water levels have receded. And we're not dealing with, real high water levels because of all the rain. So the water looks incredible today. I'm going to swing the camera around so you can take a look there. There's a bunch of midges coming off on the surface here. And I'm just excited to catch fish. I was talking to Steve, who's the owner here, who takes care of Yellow Creek Trout Club. And they stocked a week ago, so there's a bunch of fish in here. Have no idea what to expect, but I'm looking forward to catching some fish today. So I just took the water temps. It's the highest water temp I've seen this year. It's about 57 degrees right now. It's about 8:30 in the morning. And so with those warmer water temps and the sun rising high in the sky today, it can only add up to good things. So I'm looking forward to it. Meeting up with a friend here later, hoping to get her on camera, and I'm going to show you what I'm fishing with here. So I got my 5-weight Abel TR2 reel here. I got my Winston Boron 2X, which has been kind of my old faithful rod. And then on my dropper fly today, I'm going to be fishing a fresh red squirmy wormy that I tied up last night. I got that pattern off of, I think it's Tight Lines is the YouTube channel. And basically it's a squirmy wormy segment wrapped around the hook with one bead in the center. It's a size 14 hook. And it looks like something I'd want to eat if I was a trout. I know you purists aren't going to like it. It's actually the first time I've ever fished a squirmy wormy. I'm going to try it in place of a San Juan today. And then going up the line, I'm also fishing a Y2K pattern, which is a size 14 hook with a gold bead at the top, and then a split between yellow and orange antron. And then that's going up to my indicator. I have a 9-foot 5X leader on today, and that's what I'm fishing with. So when I fish out here, I like to use a styrofoam indicator. I use the airlocks sometimes in the heavier flows, but the problem is that the airlocks make a very large splash on the water. That's the one thing I don't like about them. The styrofoam is a little bit of a stealthier approach in terms of sound. That's just something I've found personally. Well, guys, I just hooked into a beautiful one here. I don't know if it's a brown or a rainbow, but it's a nice fish. Yeah, I think it's a rainbow. Really nice fish. It's the first one I've hooked into today. I'm just slightly downstream of where I started. Looks like he took the Y2K pattern, which must have liked that bright color. Man, that's a beautiful rainbow. Big fish. Look at that rainbow. Wow. A monster. Wow, what a monster. Look at that guy. So guys, I just moved downstream from where I started. And, you know, as I was showing you there at the beginning, I was just drifting my Y2K with the squirmy wormy dropper. And, I picked this beautiful rainbow up off the bottom. You just hit the Y2K. And beautiful fish. You know, maybe 18 inches or so. I don't know if he's quite 20, but heavy trout and just a beauty. So I'm gonna put him back and let's keep going. Okay, here's another spot that looks like it would hold fish. You got a nice pool formed by the rocks here. There's some deeper pockets in there. And anywhere you see those darker green pockets where, you know, you can't quite see the bottom, those are historically great fish hold spots. So I'm gonna try to get my
set up out there and drifted through there. See what happens. Oh, there it is. Look at that fish. Wow. He pounded that squirmy wormy. That was amazing. Beautiful rainbow. What a take. What a take. Look at those head shakes. You guys ever wonder why rainbows are the best trout to catch? Because of that right there. Look at that fight. That's just awesome. Bruiser. Look at those head shakes, man. Bruiser. Wow, that was awesome. Squirmy wormy. There it is.
It's almost so big I can't lift them up.
Wow, that's a big one. Look at the size of that fish. Holy cow. That is a monster rainbow. Wow. It's easily over 20. I don't even know if I can fit that in the net. Wow. Look at the size of that fish. Holy moly. Oh my gosh, that thing is huge. It's got to be the biggest rainbow trout I've ever caught.
Guys, aside from steelhead, this is the biggest rainbow trout I've ever caught in my life. It is probably, it's somewhere between 24 and a half and 25 inches. Just a freaking monster, man. This is, it's just a pig. Unbelievable. But I'm putting him back now. What a thrill to catch him. Holy cow. Wow. What a monster.
At the
Yellow Creek Trout Club, and I'm hanging out with Andrea Larko. Andrea, introduce yourself.
I'm Andrea Larko. I introduced myself.
You probably know her artwork from like Sims and Abel and who else?
Montana Fly Company.
Montana Fly Company. So she's doing me a favor and showing me some good water down here today.
It took him to the secret spot downstream.
The secret spot.
So, yeah.
The
no
secret
one really
spot.
Wants to walk the whole way down here, but there's really good fish the whole way.
When you're doing your artwork, because you're, like, what I know about artists are, they're all night owls, so they all do their artwork at night. What do you listen to music when you do your artwork?
I listen to music, yeah. I have.
Like, late at night? What are you listening to when you're...
I don't know, I've lately been getting back into my teenage years of listening to metal and...
Nice. Nothing
and
wrong with little
music
metal.
And stuff like that, because when I was in college, I used to go to a lot of shows like that, and it's fun to reminisce, so...
So let me ask you something. Do you watch, like, fly fishing videos on YouTube?
Yes, I do.
What is your opinion of a fly fishing video where guys are, like, fishing point of view with, like, a GoPro with, like, metal music in the background?
I think it's awesome.
Is that cool, or is that, like... You gotta shut
awesome.
It off. Like,
my Instagram is just at Andrea Larko, AndreaLarko.
Okay.
And my Facebook page is facebook.com/artbyandrealarko.
Awesome. So you hear that, folks?
There you go.
Go check out her Instagram and Facebook page and check her out live when she's, like, you know, up in the middle of the night listening to, like, death metal.
Yeah, that happens.
Because that's what
fly
fishing artwork
off.
Is all about.
Oh, man.
All right, well, we're going to go find some fish, and hopefully I can get Andrea on camera catching a trout or walleye or bass or something.
It'll most likely be me catching a tree, but, you know, that happens, too.
We'll see. All right, catch you soon.
Thanks for watching, guys.
Thanks.
Oh, yeah, go up the
tree. He's fighting good. That is a good fish, Andrea. Wow. Oh, it got off. Oh. Yeah, nice job.
I got one.
Finally.
Hey, be nice.
No, I'm saying that nicely, like,
oh, man.
Like finally, like relief.
And he's a bit upset. Oh gosh. Okay, buddy, just give me a minute. Stay still.
How's it feel to finally land a fish?
I think my bad luck is gone now.
Is that big brown trout?
No, it's just a big fat rainbow. Oh, come this way, buddy. Turn this way. Out of the
turn. Nice fish.
Oh, come on.
Oh, yes. Nice fish. That is a monster.
That is a really nice rainbow.
Wow, that's a really nice rainbow. Nice catch.
I can't fit my hand around him.
He's like a football.
He is a football. And I think he's really upset with me right now. He's not too happy.
That is a beautiful rainbow.
That is a really nice
rainbow. Nice fish.